Hey, what's going on, gamers? Welcome back to GamerGuide channel, and welcome back to the town of Wraulings, the town in which we're trying to get our citizens to 300 before they die of horrible causes or neglect or what have you from mismanagement. And I asked in the comments last time, would you guys mind if I skipped ahead 20 years, and didn't see any objections. So because I went on to playing binge off the Wraulings game pretty much immediately after I played last, I decided to do a little side save, and I played about 20 years, about what would have been 4 episodes, and got a long way. In fact, I decided to come back 20 years in the future because we're about 272 villagers now in total, and we're going to probably hit 300, which is our goal this episode. So this could possibly be the last episode if something horrific doesn't happen to our town. Now, you remember down here in the south part, we had set up a market last time and put down some foundations for additional houses, but it really filled out over the last 20 years. I'm going to go ahead and put it on pause for a second while I'm talking to you guys about this. But I filled in a little community. In the market, we did trade a lot of beer with surrounding neighbors, and we got all kinds of real cool crops. So these are all different stuff. Wheat, of course, you knew about, but we have also got squash now. We've got peppers, and this is all basically just trading our resources, mostly tools, iron tools, and beer is how we ended up getting it all. I remember I was telling you we're trying to figure out where to put our livestock, and here's a chicken's coop that we had put down in the last episode, but we've also now have cows and sheep. The villagers eventually brought those by from neighboring towns, and we did a little trading for beer again and for some of our leftover crops since we were real food heavy. And now I have 4 pens here. Let's continue further on, because there is actually a lot more here that's been added on. We have a second stone camp now, after all the little area here with our agricultural people. And then we have another town here at the very bottom. Well, not another town, but another little annex of Wraulings. This brand new. You guys have never seen this. It's got another market, another boarding house, and then, of course, all your trades right around the market. And I found this works really good, having the trades, like the guy who makes more beer, so this is part of the beer for the southern trading port. And then also we have our tailor, and we have our blacksmith and everything right there at the market, so they can grab the supplies, go in and make their tools, and put them right back out. And I usually like trying to have the actual trading port or post right near the market too, but I ended up just making a stone road so they can run up and down really quick. Put a secondary barn right by there to store things, and a secondary holding stockpile area too. So that's brand new. Another church on the south side, since we ran into so many people. Basically, one of the things that happened is I got a bunch of wave of nomads, and they did get bigger and bigger. I think I got about 3 or 4 in the last 20 years, and last we accepted was 41 nomads. We've pretty much accepted every wave successfully, and I gotta say, the trick to winning this for me has been beans. That's really it. If you guys can get beans, and probably second best is going to be these peppers, but both I've noticed both peppers and beans always harvest way early, or earlier than wheat and other crops, and so you get it all before the freeze comes, because that's really been the biggest adversary, is the freeze. Anyway, let me tell you a little bit more about the town, going back to that. So here in the middle, you remember this from last time. It was just that we had those 2 fields, and we put down our second boarding house down here at the south. But I filled in some more houses around the farming area to allow the farmers to get back and forth to the job quicker. I did add a squash garden on the bottom. And actually, we have crops that we don't even have planted yet. Peppers was one that we got. Squash, we did get apples, and we got pumpkins. And we have 2 pumpkin crops. And then we also got peaches, and I put peaches, or pears, excuse me, pears up here. But I think we do have peaches, actually. We could actually just go to the town center and take a look at all the stuff we've acquired, because it's a nice little way to do that. So here's everything we've picked up from neighbors. Chestnuts, I know we don't have planted. I thought I had peaches, but I guess I just have pears, so we need to still pick up peaches. But really, I mean, we started out with probably the best stuff we could have started with, so that really gave us better chances. The beans and the wheat are really 2 great things, because you can turn this into beer, and it does, I think, make your villagers more healthy having wheat, from what I've seen. I've started with other kinds of crops, but wheat was really good for health, And then beans, they harvest early. So if you harvest a bunch of little fields of beans, which is what I ended up doing here, this is kind of the breaking, would kind of turn things around for me, made it a lot better. So I had one person on each of these little small bean fields here in the main town, and that would harvest first, so we didn't have any starving in the spring while we're waiting to harvest our crops. You can see we did have a lot of people come and go. We've had, you know, 92 people, but there's not really been a major disaster since we started this town. We had some outbreaks of, I think it was, I forget what the diseases were, smallpox and some different stuff, but fortunately with the one hospital for our whole town, it's worked out really well, so we haven't had any major crisis. They just go here to the hospital, and we've been able to keep someone on staff full-time. It's just one physician. I'm probably going to need to build a second physician now, though, because we're getting so big and we're getting close to 300. Anyway, I've been talking a lot here, but yes, yeah, so this is pretty much the whole town. There is a couple little outposts that I improved. Over here on the other side, we had kind of started this wood area last time. You knew about this. This was the Forester's Lodge. We had the wood cutting station with a stockpile and a couple more houses. And I added in some more stuff, though. I put a gathering hut. I put another herbalist station so we could make enough medicine. And then I've also added a couple more little outposts, similar to that one, just where they just harvest and plant trees. So that's down here. We have one right across from the main town, right across from the stockpile, which as you see here, we've really dug that hole a lot deeper too for stone. We've got a huge reserve now of stone. So yeah, this is just another woodcutter's area with a gathering hut. And then we have another one too, right here. So my thought for this episode, we've got someone building outer stone road, very cool, is to finish things off, I'd like to try to get one more little area. And I think I'm going to do it up here to the northwest, right across from here. I have a nice little stone path going so people can get back and forth quickly. But I feel like this is a really good area right here to expand out and maybe add another market, some more fields, and put some of those crops that we haven't been able to get to yet, like the chestnuts and stuff, and then also put some more wheat and stuff so we can bring that more to market. One of the nice things here is with so many people, I haven't had to rotate out positions, and it's been more successful having people dedicated to just farming and not having to like take them all off farming and make them all build. That's kind of what you do at the beginning, but having them dedicated, it seems like they always get on farming quicker and they're more, I don't know what it is, more happy or something. I don't know if that's actually a thing, but anyway, let's look here at our trades. What do we got? We don't really need a lot of seeds. Walnut seeds, pear seeds, I don't think we need any of those. Chestnut seeds, squash seeds, we're good on those too. Bean seeds, we're good on that, of course. I don't know if we have walnuts. We might buy walnuts real quick. Let's look. Do we have walnuts? I don't see them. Not being blind here, am I? Nope. Okay, so why don't we buy walnuts from this guy? We'll take that. If we can afford it. We should be able to, though. So yeah, we have a bunch of ale. Let's go ahead and do that. And I don't even have as much as I could be putting into the market here right now. But we'll give them all 200. So that's already 1,600. And then things like our tools, that was the same values approximately. So, and we're making extra tools. So we could trade away pretty much. We're at 24 right now. All that. We can give the rest in iron. So that works. Alright, so we'll trade for the seeds. So now we have two crops. We could plant chestnuts and we could plant walnuts. We could have like a little nut farm going on with some wheat and beans and a market and all that kind of good stuff up here on top. So let's go ahead and let's put that down as our farmers are getting the bean crops ready. And you can see that they're already, you know, at 43 and 45% yield, and it's just springtime. So they really pop up early, and they're ready to harvest, and that's kind of been our most successful crop, I think, as far as keeping everybody fed. So we got a big one here that has multiple farmers for on that, and we got a couple of smaller, mid-sized ones here down by the other church. But yeah, we really became an agricultural giant. And then basically all the wheat all goes to the breweries to be turned into marketable product in our three taverns. We could probably add another tavern up here on the north, too. Another pepper farm. Now, I find that peppers seem to harvest right after beans. So they're maybe like the next little changing of the season. So if it's spring and late spring or early summer, they would harvest. So It's not a full season usually, but a little bit later in the season or right at the turn. Okay, so let's go ahead and plan out our next little expansion. I think if we hit it right in the middle here and we don't go too far, we'll be fine. And we do have a lot of stone, and I want to make a stone road, as getting those villagers back and forth is kind of a very critical part to being successful. So I'm going to come out here, because I don't want to be too close to our little gathering hut and forester's area. So I think if we start the barn right about there, and we do have 16 people on laborers. In fact, that's way too much. I've been kind of talking to you and haven't noticed that we have somebody on that. So I'm going to go ahead and put like 4 people, or maybe 5 people on building, and I'm going to go ahead and bump up our market people too. And I think that's been another thing that's been very, made things very successful, is I've increased our vendor count. I have basically on each of the different markets tried to keep 4 or 5. So now right now it's 5 on each. But I'm going to probably bring that up again. All right, merchant has arrived at the trading post. Another thing too is having these double posts, we get more merchants. And so we've been able to trade for more stuff. Let's see. Oh, I thought this is the same merchant, isn't it? Is there one down here now? Yeah, there is. Okay. I've never had 2 merchants come at the exact same time. That's interesting. We can get a couple more cattle, but I don't think we need them because our cattle are both all the way full. And we can just split our cattle herds if we come up with a new one. So I'm going to go ahead and dismiss both these guys. Let's see, is there anything that we don't have food-wise? I don't think we have corn. So before we let him go, let's go ahead and just take, like, whatever we can get. We've already replenished some of our ale into the market, so why don't we just bump this up by 100, and we'll take 800 corn, and then we'll let him go. So we can make everything else. We're pretty self-sufficient now. So let's trade. Yep, trade for that, and dismiss. And we'll let this guy go, too. It'd be kind of cool if they had some more animals that you could get. You know, different things, maybe things for transportation, like horses and stuff. And there might be in the mods. There is a good Steam market for this. I just haven't really played a lot with modding. I just wanted to kind of play the vanilla game and win for the first time, or get to 300, as I kind of say, win. It's not really a win. I think you can kind of play this forever. But I'm planning to just take this to 300... or maybe slightly beyond, you know, but it won't be something I do on camera, most likely. Now, one thing is we have reached our limit here on firewood. I'm going to go ahead and bump it up because we can sell some of that, and we'll probably just supply more on the market now. So let's go up to 2,000 for firewood. But as you can see, we're not at risk of starving to death. I mean, we have a max 20,000 food right now. And yes, our food stores are getting low, but as soon as autumn hits, or 10,000 is not really low, but not 20,000. But you'll see this number just blow up in autumn when we start harvesting all these fields. And plus, we're getting food full-time now, too, from these different herds, at least the cattle and the chickens. And so it's working out really good. Anyway, how are we doing up here? Are we getting the road done? And what can we add to? I think I'm going to go ahead and put some more, like I was saying, more vendors. We're going to go up to... we have... Okay, that will be 6 on each right now, so that's fine, because we're gonna end up taking some of them off to be put onto a new market here. So let's see how quickly they can put something together. We'll go ahead and start with a stockpile, and I think this is a good way to start. This is kind of getting an area down where they can actually dump off the stuff that they're going to be harvesting from the area to make it clear. So we'll do a big stockpile, and then we'll go ahead and... my screen went black for a second. Not sure what happened there, guys. Sorry. Anyway, we'll go ahead and we will turn a barn right there. Actually, let's go ahead and take this off. I want to get it right up on the road. We got somebody coming out for that stockpile already. That's good. We got to put our builders to work. We have 5 of them and they're not really doing much. Alright, let's pause here for a second. Okay, so we're going to have the barn in the market. Let's go ahead and put down some new fields around the area. Oh, again, my screen's going black. I'm not sure exactly why that's happening, but I don't think I have a problem with my... There must be something interfering with the game's screen. Anyway, it's not persistent, so let's go ahead and we'll go over to our crops now, pick up a orchard. And we want at least one. I want them pretty close here. Let's go ahead and cancel that. I want to try to split it so we're right. We have both of them real close to the barn. So let's see. Orchard. That's fine. Right across the way. And we can make these 15 by 15 if I remember right. So we're going to go ahead and do that. And we'll leave a spot for a road in between. So we'll come out one more and then we'll do another 15 by 15. And having that storage yard right across the way should help with these rocks and trees and all that kind of good stuff. Alright, we're also going to need houses, of course. But first, let's just go ahead and finish up putting our fields down. I do want to have at least one field here. We're going to go full size. We'll probably make this a wheat field. And I'm probably going to do a large bean field, too. Let's see, 15 by 15. It can't be that hard to get this here. 13, 14, 15, 15, 15. There we go. We could even just do a little small one. Just do a little mini bean field back here. Just to kind of fill out the area. Why don't we go like... we don't really need to butt a road right up there. So we could do like an 11 by... we'll do a 5 by 15 back there. That's something different. Alright, this is getting cleared out. Why don't we put the market... we should put it back there. We could have them walk a little bit. Yeah, we're going to go ahead and put the market in the back here. But we will run another road across the way, up here. Kind of go right alongside it. And this is kind of where we'll have everything centered, all the industry stuff around it. Okay, we're going to have to take that out. Oop. I selected remove roads. Okay, this can go away. We'll put the market right there. There we go. And then around the market... Alright, we got our first freeze. Nice thing about having lots of laborers is they auto-fill in for the people who've died, so that's always cool. What are we at right now? We're at 209 adults, 40 students, and 23 youngsters. And we also probably need to build a school up here, and I probably shouldn't wait too long on that because last I checked, our students... We're getting pretty high. We have two of our schools. We actually have three schools to get all together. So we could get up to 60, but we might want to put another school just because that doesn't mean logistically that they're able to get to, you know, the school they want to. There might be more people up at the top one to the south. Alright, they are building this out pretty well. Alright, so one of the things we could do is make a little neighborhood area or a little living quarter here across from the stockpile. And also I want to build our chopper right there too, our wood chopper area. Does it kind of make sense? And also having it right next to the market would be a smart thing to do. Now I believe that could be a road up there. So we'll build that there. We'll put a house, stone house, right here at the road. And we're gonna go ahead and put another one here right at the entrance. Now, probably would be a smart idea to have a well near the market or near an area where if something, fire breaks out, we don't lose our important stuff. So we'll go ahead and put that one off there. And how about another tailor? That could be good. Do that right here, kind of sharing the common road with the market. And we'll put another stone house up top. I can't do it right there. Looks like that little hill is going to be right in the way. We could maybe make a mine right there. be interesting having an Omarion right at the market, but I guess if they have to dump it off somewhere, it'd be pretty handy. I'm going to give it a little room just in case we can. Oh, we got a trader. Let's go back, and we'll continue looking at that in a second. What did you bring me today? We have coal, iron tools, and firewood. We're not at risk of needing any of this stuff, so I'm going to go ahead and dismiss. And we don't really need any of your crops. You know, later on, too, after I got a couple different food varieties, I stopped ordering things. And the difference in price being $2,500 to $3,600 if you order it is pretty huge. So I like the just waiting and being patient and eventually it coming without you having to order it seems to be a lot better as far as price. Alright, let's see. We got those walnuts done. We need chestnuts. Those are the two new crops that we've never had before. And let's go ahead and just for the sake of speed, we're going to run a stone road down the access point there. We can afford it. We have a stockpile of stone. And we'll go ahead and run this all the way around. And then we can go ahead and make this whole area here, too, stone. We're kind of setting up a good infrastructure. Here at the far side, we've, guess I'll run a stone road down here, too. There's a big difference in travel speed between people walking on stone roads and dirt roads. So, essentially, put down stone roads on all the major thoroughfares, and you'll have better success at quick travel times and less villagers running out of certain things they need, like firewood or food or whatever you may have. I'm going to go ahead and run a little bit more stone here, too, while we're talking about it. Might as well put some more down. Because last I checked, that stockpile was looking pretty full over there by the main mining pit. Yeah, we still got hordes of stone, so. Yup. Okay, let's see. Up here, what do we actually have? 450 stone? So that should last a little bit. Let's hit this guy. Let's see what he's got here at the trading post. We got wheat seeds and cherry seeds. Maybe cherry seeds? I don't remember. I don't... Yeah, we did have cherries. I think cherries is our first crop, if I remember right. It was... I remember talking about cherry sandwiches. Cherry fish sandwiches. Yeah, so we're good on that. Let's go back over there. We'll just dismiss that dude. Probably he'll leave eventually. We don't need to go to the market every single time, I suppose. But I just am in the habit of being a micromanager here. Okay, so what did we do last? We were going to see if we could get a mine shaft right there on the corner. Yeah, it's not quite big enough for the hill. Oh, hold on. We're getting pretty close. That would be kind of semi-right in town. No, okay. I don't think it's going to happen because we just have one little pixel off. One little block does not work. So, it was a nice idea. Let's see. Do we need anything else as far as major services? I know we're pretty good on tools. We got 211. I don't think we need to necessarily build another one of those. We could do another tavern just for the sake of it. And it wouldn't be bad to have an herbalist not too far away. So we have a lot of our stuff there. I'm going to go and put the herbalist hut right here because it needs to be out in the forest area to really gather the things it needs. But I will put another house down right by the herbalist to just give them a place to live when they're working. So let's go ahead and we'll add a couple more houses here and there of the stone variety. Already got those planted. That's looking good. And did we choose... Oh, we still got some removal to do in both these. I guess over here we can choose another crop, too. So let's go ahead and we'll put one more down. And I'm going to probably make this one beans, just because of the speed. I think we actually have one of everything else as far as the crops go planted already. We can go and get that removed, and we don't necessarily need a stone path there. We'll just do a dirt one to save a little stone for houses and things. And then here on the back, we could go another stone. I guess that wouldn't hurt anything. And then we'll put maybe another row of houses. We actually have lots of room here. We could continue on with orchards and fields and stuff. But we do have to have... I do like having my villagers live nearby, so why don't we make a row of houses out here between the crops if we end up doing another row of trees or something so they can live amongst their work. Alright, we got a mountain right there, so maybe that is going to stop us. Right here we don't. Now, does this go away on the side? Yeah, it does. So we could run a road right down through here. Go ahead and move that over one spot. Plop down a couple houses together, making of stone, so we don't have a fire problem. Okay, good. They went ahead and finished this. So let's see. Potato, pumpkin, squash, peppers. I think we're good. I think we're going to do wheat in that big field. And let's go ahead and up our farmers. We can now have up to 65 farmers total. And we can certainly get close to that. So here we're going to go ahead and let's do another variety crop. I said I was going to do beans, but we also have that area. I guess we'll go ahead and do a smaller bean one. And we'll do the bigger of some other one of these. Okay, so that will automatically port some of our merchants over. Logistics is very important to be successful in this game, and part of the thing is having enough people in the vendor markets and stuff to be able to run out, grab things from the other barns and from neighboring suburbs or little areas you've built, basically, different drop-off points and mines and stuff, and then bring it back to the market. And if you don't have someone able to run and also tend to the market or enough people, your villagers will start starving and dying and stuff. And I kind of found that out the hard way on another game I'd played off camera with Banished, in which I wasn't real successful. But I think when I analyzed what did I do wrong, I think it's just I didn't have enough vendors because no one could really get supplies outside of their area and stuff. So ended up kind of being a disaster. So make sure you have enough people vending your market. Right now I have 4 in each of the markets, 4 people. I might actually, now that I have 4 markets, I might want to actually make that 5 in each of them, so I should have 20 total vendors. So I'm going to go ahead and up this by 2. And we'll go ahead and do... do we want to do 2 more traders? Good. I'm going to go ahead and do 2 more traders. This is... Well, actually, I'm not, because traders is not as important. We don't need to really trade with nearby towns, and they can take the time to bring things in and out. So vendors, I think, more important than traders from what I've seen. Brewers, we're a little light on. We'll go ahead and bump that back up. Going to make 3 brewers. That's what I'll go ahead and put in. I'll put in another brewery. Or another tavern, as they call it. I'm calling them breweries, because that's kind of what they're becoming. Just making Wraulings beer. So here we go. Put another one right by that market. We have a tailor. We're just going to forego the tools, so that will be something we'll need to import from the main city hub here, where we have our blacksmith down here at the south. Our main one, at least. There it is. We're still doing iron tools. And what does our coal look like? I think I'm going to go ahead and switch that over now to steel tools. I'd rather... I think steel tools last a little bit longer and they're more efficient, so no reason to really be using iron anymore. Let's see. We have our gathering huts all the way at the max for bringing in herbs. So why don't we increase that now to 500. And we are well over 20,000 food, so we are killing it. We could go ahead and put some of this in the market. And now I might actually, if I increase this and we do a little bit of output. And this is kind of a good way to store food too, in case you run into a problem for some unforeseen reason, like a disaster or something. It'd be a good way to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to have them hold a little bit of food there. Actually, we could look at our inventory at the market. Let's go ahead and increase food, because I want them to continue to harvest it. I don't want them to stop. Because we can sell off the stuff we don't use, essentially, is what's going to happen. So we will go ahead and do that. Continue. Anyway, this is what I was talking about. We have our inventory. It shows quantities of stuff, so we can, very useful, we can see exactly what we have that's marketable, and that's something I didn't really know about before. Look at all the wheat we have. That should be going to the taverns, but we could definitely put some on the market. So we'll increase wheat by, I think, 1,000. And I'd taken food off and just had them providing from the cells and just trading things that were not food essential, namely beer. And speaking of which, while we're here, let's go ahead and up that. It's 200 is kind of ridiculously low. I'm going to go ahead and make that 400. So we're increasing that. We're going to put some raw material on the market. 1,000 wheat. Sounds good. And we'll just, in case we do see some crops, seeds that we want, we can then trade for them. And let's see, what else do we have, like, just a abundance of at the market? I'll have to go back and look here. We also have a lot of onions, ridiculous amount. Oh, a lot of fish, tons of fish. Those and beans, actually, we have a huge amount of. I guess we have just kind of overdone it on beans because it was a way to make sure that no one's died, you know. If you run out of stuff to eat, you can always have beans. The musical fruit. The more you eat, the more you toot. There we go. So we have a very gastrally energized crowd here at Wraulings. All right, so I have 1,000 of that. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and make that 2,000 because we just do have a ridiculous amount of beans. Oh, there's another vendor. And what did you actually bring me? Let's see, we have leather, warm coats. Warm coats wouldn't be a bad idea. Hide coats, firewood. We really don't need anything. Maybe leather? And the raw resources we could use to make our own clothes. Alright. That's annoying. Let's go ahead and buy up the leather. We'll take it all. 1,000. And we'll trade you. Get rid of some of this iron. I'm not really going through it. Oh, I'm overpaying. Alright. Is there anything interesting you have? No. Okay. Bye-bye. We're about to get another one. I saw him passing. Let's see what he's going to trade down here. And how are we looking? Pretty good. Got some more foresters dying of old age. Besides that, here in year 47, things are going pretty well. I don't think we've really changed too much in population. If we get a crop, another batch of nomads at the town center, that will put us over the limit. Alright, for sure. Cherry, walnuts, peach. Ah, we do need that. And one thing different, too, is both of these have their own supply of stuff, so I'm not actually sure I'm going to be able to afford these peach seeds. If they had gone to the top market, I probably would have. I forgot about that. I probably should put more stuff here in the south. But let's just try real quick. 1,000 there. Firewood. Alright. I'm going to be able to do this. Yes, we're overpaying by 20. So let's just pull this. Not going to be super precise about it. We'll overpay a little bit. Let's go ahead and get that peach seed and squash seeds. We're good on. We got some beef, but we're already making our own beef. We really don't need theirs. That's all we really need. Our tool supply is good, so let's go ahead and dismiss. And actually, we can go ahead and add another orchard here to the top. Oh, I just received an award. Foodie. Let's check this out. Okay, well, I'm guessing that means having a wide variety. I might have to look at what that award actually is, but I imagine it's just for having a huge variety of food. We have everything but three different foods. I don't know what those are, but I know, I do know. One of them is cabbage. That's something that I always buy when it comes in. We've never seen cabbage seeds. All right, here we're going to do beans. I know that's super boring, but it's just good to have, because, like I said, they harvest before anything else, and they keep us eating. For a huge population, it's always a good thing. I have a couple different... I'm thinking we're going to do another potatoes. Wheat. We have lots of wheat. We'll do a potatoes. Let's go ahead and continue here with our road here on the side. Run this all the way up and around just so they can get and collect from anywhere around here and get back on the road quickly. And we'll go ahead and put a couple houses here on the far side just so they can be near their work again. Logistically, it works out well. Put one there. They really should be calling this game Logistics the Game, because it feels like what that was at university when I was there studying. I liked logistics a lot, but playing this, I realized basically that's what you're playing. Oh, this is the first time I've ever seen a building catch fire. Okay, so this is the first. It is the stone gatherer's place? Now, how do we put it out, or does it automatically put out? Oh, well look, yeah, it's automatically put out. This is kind of cool. They just grab water from the nearest well, which was conveniently placed right next to where the fire is, and they're all running over to get it. And I think we're going to put this fire out. I will be very surprised if it destroys other buildings with all the villagers I see here right now. And we have 10 laborers on it. It's like a continual stream of people putting it out, so I wish there was a status, like, okay, it's been severely damaged, but everybody chilled out. Let's go ahead and rebuild. Even though this is almost empty, that probably wasn't, oh, it was just a house. Okay, it wasn't the actual quarry. I built it so close, though, it looks like it was. But we'll go ahead and we'll rebuild that. And one thing I had actually done is upgrade these to stone, kind of one at a time. That was one of them I had done, I believe. So we're going to go ahead and reclaim that. Rebuild. I guess we're just waiting on people. Well, we're at regular speed. That's what's going on. Let's get back to the 10x. And let's go ahead, while we're at it too, let's upgrade some of these other houses. The nice little thing is you can just click this button here and it automatically upgrades houses. So boots the people out for a short time, and so you don't want to upgrade too many houses at once, but if you have plenty of the, what are they called, boarding houses, you're good. They can live there if it's an emergency, or if, you know, you have a huge fire. All right, we had a couple people die of old age, and we have some replacements for them, fortunately. Okay, so we have this mapped out. We do have some new houses and a tavern being built. Here on the backside, I'm going to go ahead and add that road here to the south, just to get us beyond so we can add some more fields down here eventually. And we could probably put another house or two here behind. I'm going to leave a spot open for another well, because that just saved our butt by having one so close. We're going to have another one right there. And I've been pretty diligent about putting wells down, just because I think they're kind of cool looking, actually. But that's the first time I've ever seen a fire break out, and it's been 48 years in our town. So I guess it does happen, but it's just, you know, very rare. So that was kind of neat to see for the first time. Hide coats. Let's go ahead and do warm wool coats. And let's go ahead and put another person on tailoring, too. Core. So I have another position filled there. Nomads have arrived at our town center. Didn't even notice that. Well, guys, this might be it. I think we're about to get to 300 right here. Look at all the nomads. They're all in the grayed out uniforms, but that is definitely... What do we have right now? We have 58... Call it 50, plus that is 67. 67 plus 8 is... what, 75? So we need 25 people. If there's 25 people here and we take them in, we're gonna get to our goal right now. Yep, 38. That will put us over. So if I do allow, we have actually won the game. So this will probably be the last episode that I play on camera. But we've accomplished our goal. So, and actually, when I do this, I should also get some awards and stuff like that for getting 300 villagers. I believe that's what happens. So that is pretty cool. Looks like we don't have quite enough farmers, but we'll bump this all the way up to 71 farmers here in a second. I'm going to go ahead and finish out this episode. We're not going to stop at 48. I am going to go to year 50. But, yeah, looks like we're going to win. So I'm going to go ahead and accept them, guys. Nice. I've received an award. Settlement. That's the one. That's the one I needed. So we are now over 300 villagers. They're all going to go to the market and find one of our boarding houses to settle in. You know, another thing we could do is we could put a second hospital up there. But now we have 28 more laborers, and how many kids did we pick up? God, we picked up a lot, like 25, but I'm not worried about it because we have so much food. And we are in early summer, so even with that many people, I think 10,000 food is going to suffice. I'm going to go ahead and put these guys on farming right away, so I want all our crops that can be harvested to be harvested. What else can I do? I did up our vendor counts, but with that many more people, might be good to even up it a little more. Right now we have 5 at each of the markets. So, should I make it 6? We have the people. Couldn't really hurt. Foresters, let's go ahead and put a couple more on that. What are we actually getting low on? Miners, we could actually use some more miners. So let's do that. Keep our coal up. Keep our raw resources. Iron is actually getting low too, so I'm saying actually a lot, I'm noticing. So we'll go ahead and do that. And tavern, awesome. We're going to use wheat again. Though beans would be great if we could actually produce beer out of beans, but that's just not a thing. Let's also put down another hospital. I think sickness might be a thing in our little town. I'm going to put a hospital right here, actually. Boom. Go. I might have put that house too close, yeah. Well, that's the way. We'll run it around the house. And we'll put the hospital right here on the road. Actually, no. I don't want to put it right there because that will run into our little gathering area. Where would be a great place for a hospital? Maybe out here on the outskirts where there's not a lot of people because I don't want other people getting infected. So why don't we make this little area? Here. Let's cancel that. Actually come into right there, I guess, is where we had stopped. So make this kind of a major thoroughfare. Come across here in front of these other houses, connect up this road, and then here on the corner we'll make another hospital. So town services, hospital. Excuse me. Where are you, hospital? There you are. So now we have a second hospital. I'll put it down a little further. We'll put it right here. And we'll put a little house for the guy to live in that's going to be our physician. And let's go ahead and put another school in, too. I'm sure that that is going to cap out what we're able to take in. Where would be a good place for school? I think right here by the bar. We're putting a school right by a bar. It sounds like a disastrous idea. Normally, in our day and age, but maybe the kids will have fun. They'll have a little beer, you know, between classes. Alright, so we'll throw this through there, and let's throw in our town service school right behind here, right by the market. Can we fit it in there? It's always a problem with that, huh? Well, we could do it this way. So we'll do the school here between, like that. And we'll go ahead and put the road right behind it. Well, this is cool. I'm glad we have been successful. This is actually it's obviously the first time because I got the achievement, but first time I've played this game and done so well. So I'm glad it was on camera. I tried a couple times before, but there's always a hurricane that would come through or a tornado and kill everybody, or people would just start dying because of the logistics problem with not enough people, not enough vendors. But this time's gone really pretty smoothly. Now we could also add another church. That may not be a bad idea. We could put that up here north of the town. So let's go ahead and do that. Put it right near the school. Let's make it for people to get back and forth a little easier. all the services I need. They're all kind of right in the same vicinity. And if we were going to put down a blacksmith, I guess that would be a great spot for one. I'm not really convinced that we need another one, but... yeah, I'm going to go ahead and put it there, because it's closer to the market than the other stuff. And we're going to go and make this all a stone road, too. Reserve of stone is low. Well, we finally run out of our stone that we've been using on everything. I mean, we literally brought in a huge annex here. Alright, we are back up at almost 20,000 before early winter. I think we're going to be fine. Let's see, do we have... maybe let's get a couple more herbalists on. And gatherers, we're going to increase that up to 20. Wouldn't be a bad idea to have a secondary herd place for these people up here on the north side. So we could do that, I suppose. Maybe back over here. Let's do that. Let's just put a stable down. I might continue this off camera. Let's see. Let's do a 20 by 20 here. And we'll probably end up making that wool or something like that. What are we at the max at? Max of clothing. Okay, so we'll go ahead and increase that. And we got people dying and being replaced. That was our graveyard now. It's probably getting really... not too bad. I notice these disappear out over time. Might be kind of fun to follow one of our little people around, see what they what their daily life is like. We've got some farmers here. What about one of these citizens just wandering around? Okay, that one's one of the traders, it looks like. Super happy, super healthy, educated. I don't think we have any children that have come in that are uneducated. Because we have so many schools everywhere. Doesn't seem to be a need for anything. No one's requesting houses or anything like that. This is all going pretty well. It's kind of self-sustaining, honestly. I think I feel like, aside from the disasters, which usually are taken care of, except for things like pestilence, which you have to tell them to chop down a field or something like that. We have a lot of people dying, though. I have noticed that here. Merchant has arrived, trading post. But aside from those occasional disasters, or, you know, maybe a tornado wrecking things, this is pretty self-sustaining now. I've gotten it to a pretty good balance. You know, I have to tell people, you know, what to bring in and stuff. Corn seeds. Do we have corn? No, I think we do. I think that's one of the things we need. Corn. Okay, corn, cabbage. Yeah, I don't have any corn seeds. So let's go ahead and take the corn. Pretty cool. They have cabbage seeds too. Awesome. And, well, let's see if we can pay for those first two things. Get this up to 400. That's 5,000 total. So as you can see, I mean, I only have 400 beer on the market. But it is worth a lot. So, you know, right there, 3,200. Made a huge dent in things. And the rest I'm paying with tools, a lot of tools. And we're not really... we can replace most of these. I don't want to get rid of them all because they're going to have to pull these right from what we have for raw supply. And I don't want to leave people toolless, so I'm not going to put all that out there. We'll go ahead and put our coats out. All those can go. And firewood, sure. Good on that. Perfect. Alright, we are getting close to not needing anything now. We now have cabbage, corn, and gosh, I wish I knew what that was. Well, when I see it in the market, I'll know. But we can go and put a cabbage and corn crop somewhere. Maybe up here, since this is kind of another agricultural little area. We could put another crop right here. Well, that's the, okay, that's the field we've already done. Let me do a small one in between here, just for fun. How small do we want to go? Maybe a 10 by 10? We'll put it right between the houses here. We'll do a 12 by 12. And clear that out. So here's the beans. And what is it? Right now we're in early summer, late spring, and they've already cultivated. So if you guys get one crop to choose from, grab beans. That's kind of what I've learned here. And that will help you get a long way in your town being successful. Crushed by a rock, replaced by a miner, died during childbirth. I think a lot of this is just because we have so many people now. You have more people dying of random things, and we do have a lot of older citizens, too. So that was a good time to get a bachelor of kids, for sure. We're all the way at max for firewood. I'm going to go ahead and increase the firewood, and I'm also going to throw some in the markets. So if I do continue, or did continue off camera, that would be a resource that we could be selling off. Where's firewood? Logs. That's the raw resource. Here it is. Yeah, so we'll go from 100 to 1,000. And we're going to go ahead and carry some of the ale down here, too. How are we doing on it right now? Beer, actually a little bit light on it. I'm gonna put 100. And we do have brewers. Everyone? No, we don't. Okay, so we have one of our brewers die. We weren't able to replace him. So when we get some new people coming out of school, we have 32 in school, we'll go ahead and replace them on that. A lot of people dying of old age. A lot of rock crushings, too. They've got to be more careful with the rocks around here. It's two in the same year. Another trading post thing. Do you have our last seed? That would be really cool. But I don't see you carrying anything of the sort. Let's see. Is there any clues here? Squash, pepper. Pepper we have. Pears. We have mushrooms. It's not something you can grow. Herbs, corn, chicken, cherries, berries. Berries are from gatherers. Beans. Yeah, I don't know what it is. Really strange. Venison, potatoes. Roots is gatherers. Pecans. Is it pecans? No, I think we have pecans. I'm super curious, though. What is it? Pecans. It could be one of those nuts. That would make sense. Pecans. Are you there? Don't see. That's what it is. It's pecans. Okay, so if they had pecan seeds, we would complete having every crop type. But I don't think any of this is seeds. It's just, yeah. Can I get seeds from you? No. And this is gonna, we're gonna be at year 50 real soon here too, so. If I do play be past 50, year 50, that would be one thing I'd be looking for in the market. So I'll just put an order out for something like that when it comes out. Do we have any new people yet? No. We have a ton of farmers, though. And we're in early autumn, so we're going to be getting our numbers shooting up here for food. So I'm not really at risk of ever running out. Which is one of the things I thought was going to be a major factor, but I pretty much killed it with the strategy I had of selling off some of those and keeping kind of food internalized, but making it plentiful. Alright, we're getting that second pasture going. We're chopping that up. And what else do we need? Oh, we have another disaster. So, infestation, of course, with more little areas here. You have more opportunity for infestation. This is the infested area? I guess there is a green glow there. Let's go ahead and cut it down. And we do have three people in labor, so that's good. I need to put one of those on Brewer here afterwards, but we're going to go ahead and wait till they get these trees chopped down. I'm going to go ahead and watch it and speed things up. Alright, we got a couple people working it. Now, we don't really have any other orchards right by, and I think it really spreads mostly to orchards, not so much to the other kind of crop types. But we'll go ahead and replant apples immediately after this all gets chopped down. Watching them go. What's this guy here? I'm trying to click on him, but he's too damn speedy for me. Slow down, sir. Okay. Well, we got our apple wood, and we'll go ahead and replant this. I guess it's gonna automatically do it. Well, that takes care of that. Those infestations are never really a major problem. As long as you click the right button to cut it down immediately and you have enough people to do it. Alright, so we've taken care of that disaster, and we'll go ahead and put another person on brewing. Doing pretty good on wood gathering. Put another person on wood cutting, because we were having a hard time keeping up with the numbers there. And we're coming into year 50, the home stretch. What did you bring us? Squash seeds and cabbage seeds. Well, we just got cabbage seeds and we have squash seeds, so what I'll do is I'm going to go ahead and place an order for pecan seeds. Where are the... Do you have them anywhere? You don't have pecan seeds. Bummer. Okay, because I would definitely order... Oh, here they are. Derp. Just didn't see it. Alright, we're going to do that on the next visit, so we will have pecan seeds in short order, and I'm willing to pay a little bit more for them. I'll pay the full price on this. That will give us every food variety possible. And soon we'll have a giant ranch. Oh, we already have it up there. Let's go ahead and... Should we make it sheep? It would be really good for providing clothes. And we also get mutton. We do get meat off it. We're going to make it sheep, and we're going to split our herd. Since we have two stockpiles of cows. And we're going to put another person on the herdsman. Excuse me again. So we'll take that person there, and as soon as some more people graduate from school, they will become herdsmen as well. So we'll watch our sheep as they make their way across our farm. I like how they're like auto-led. They don't need anybody to show them. They just know. Go to the other pen. And like good sheep, they already know where the new pen is. And they're like homed into it. They must take directions very well. Wow, look at all the death. Holy cow. Old age, old age, old age. I'm not sad when it's the old age. I mean, if they die of some weird disease or something like that, I would feel guilty, but those are full lives. They've had happy lives, too. Five-star lives. Full, you know, five health hearts, too, and all that kind of good stuff, so. This has been quite successful. Let's see, now we could do corn or cabbage. I think we're going to go and do corn, as you can do more with that, generally, than cabbage. And where can we put a little cabbage field, though? We have room by the market, possibly. Maybe behind the market? That could be cool. Yeah, look. Right behind here, we have a little room. So we'll put it right there. Leaving the spot. And we'll just make it as big as it will let us. Can we do a 15 by 15? Yeah. Alright. And we'll go ahead and build this stone road all the way out. And a couple more houses here right behind on the other side of the road. There we go. Look at him go. These guys are on it. Merchant has arrived to the trading post. Could this possibly be the pecan seeds? That would be awesome. Plum seeds and chestnut seeds. Nope, but we're going to go and put an order in with them too for pecan seeds for next time. So at some future date, ideally, we would be getting those in Wraulings. Alright, dismiss. And back up here at our new little offshoot area. Okay, we need a teacher. That would be very helpful. So another teacher. In fact, two more teachers. In fact, that's bad. We probably could have a lot more students if we had more teachers. So we're going to go four teachers for a maximum. I think it's 20 on each of these. So of 80 kids that are educated. Didn't realize that we had some teacher deaths. Not good. Oh, look at all the people who just became students. So yeah, we definitely had a demand for that. Tons of them are becoming students, so that's good. I guess we didn't wait too long, and this must be just the right time for them to be starting. People dying of old age. Okay, we got people graduating, though. Reserve of tools is low, so we could go ahead and put another person on blacksmith. I'm going to make both those people blacksmiths. And iron tools, I think, are made quicker. We still have plenty of coal, so I'm going to go ahead and we're going to do steel tools there, too. A merchant! Do you have the fabled pecan seeds? That would be cool. No, plum seeds. Things we don't need, but we're going to go and order from you too. We're pretty much ordering from like every village out there with these pecan seeds. So we will get them for sure. Anything that could be beneficial? Venison, peaches. Do you actually, we don't actually have pecans. Well, we don't really have any corn yet, per se, or cabbage. But everything else we're able to produce. And it's autumn, and our crops are going through the roof, so I'm just going to dismiss this guy. We are self-sustained here in Wraulings. We pretty much are the major city out there in the banished world. Or at least it seems that way, for sure, because we are an agricultural hub that makes beer and has every kinds of animal you could possibly want. Okay. In this game, at least. Corn, cabbage. Now, let's see, what was it? Was it cabbage that we were going to do? Yeah, we did corn down here, if I remember right. Right? Corn. So we'll go ahead and make this one cabbage. There we go. And now we can have up to 78 farmers, so I'm going to go ahead and increase the number of farmers when we have some grads. And we have some more people graduate, so start slowly upping this number here. Foresters dying. Well, that's pretty much it, guys. We're in year 50, winter. I guess I'll just go ahead and stop this as soon as spring comes, because that will be year 51. What do we end up with at the end here? That's 85, or just make that 116 plus 521, or 321, something like that, for total population so far. And everything's looking pretty good, people are happy. Here's our total inventory, our count on things. Doing pretty good on warm coats and wool coats. Look at all the beans, good lord. But that is, I think that's been the key to victory. I'm going to put a couple thousand beans here in the market. Let's put another 2,000. We get rid of some of that stockpile. Throw it in there. We're only 23% full anyway in there. So send those guys out to do that. Alright, let's see. We lost a forester earlier. I'm going to put someone on there. And someone just died. Was it Gatherer? So I can see how this could get harder after you get over 300. I mean, things just happen so quickly. And if you run out of extra laborers, It's easy to miss someone who died that was really important, like a physician. We could get to put a one-up bar on or have another cleric, which we should have three on anyway. So it's just all about micromanagement, essentially. And that's it, I guess. We did it. I'm proud of myself, I guess. Our little effort here in Wraulings has been very successful. We have a happy town. And we've got every kind of food. Again, I think just building things around your market really close and having the logistics worked out so people don't have to walk across the map to go to their home or to get their resources and get them to the back to the house. That's really been what has made this work for me. So if you try something on your own with Banished, try that similar strategy. Try to keep everything kind of pulled together and with the fields out on the surrounding area. Oh, more nomads. Wow. Well, we're really going to kill it now. How many nomads could we get possibly at this time? 57. Holy cow. That would put us almost at 400 citizens. Do we want to do it? Absolutely. We take everybody here. I received a reward. Immigrants. Not sure what that means, but maybe it's just for accepting all nomads. I'm guessing that's probably what it is. Alright, what did you bring us today? Tell me... No, didn't bring us Nazis. Damn it. Alright, well, go away. We don't want you. Alright, that little thing, house above their head, means I need to build a lot more houses. We just ended up with, what, 33 laborers? But we can go... That's kind of cool, though. We can finish out this episode by putting pretty much people where they need to go to fill out our services and making sure that everybody's happy. More physicians, more teachers. We'll go ahead and put more people on stone cutting. What else? We'll put another person on trading since we lost one there. In fact, we're going to increase that all around. Brewers, yes, very important. Herdsmen, 10. And look, we still have 20 people. We're going to take all this all the way up to 78. Maxing out our farm. And we still have people left over. Herbalists, we'll go ahead and do 6. Sounds good to me. Woodcutters, we're going to need more people there now that we have more people in town. In fact, we'll increase that up to 7, just at the max. More hunters, like that venison. And more venison sandwiches. And fishermen, why not? And I think that's where I'm going to leave it, guys. So this has been Banished. It's been a fun game. Glad some of you came along on the ride and checked out this Let's Play. And I'll be picking up another game most likely, and we'll be playing that instead of Banished in the future. But please thumbs up the video if you enjoyed the series. Oh look, an outbreak of Scarlet Fever has occurred, but that's why we have physicians, so. Let's go ahead and look at that real quick. Go ahead and thumbs up the video if you enjoyed it. I'm not sure why I'm not able to go to a Scarlet Fever. Where are you? Usually you can click on this and it'll take you there. But not now. Anyway, I'm sure wherever the person with Scarlet Fever is, he'll be taken care of. What else can I say? Come back for more Robocraft videos. We're going to be exploring some of the new stuff coming out in October. Mech legs are going to be coming soon. Here's the person with Scarlet Fever. Are you going to be treated? Yeah, it looks like he's making a beeline towards the hospital here on the south side. Yeah, it's already registered as a patient down there. So thanks a lot for joining me. I know this was not the most popular thing I do on the channel. I'm kind of the guy who... Oh, look, there's another one. Kind of the guy who does the Robocraft innovative videos and stuff like that. But I appreciate those of you who enjoyed this being along for the ride and leaving comments and good stuff like that. Yeah, it looks like that's not going to be a major outbreak here at the end of it. So anyway, that's it. And I'll see you guys in my next video here on GamerGuide channel. Later.